Hello, this is Mobis Philippos and welcome to Mint's Mark to Market show, where we discuss market moving news and trends. On today's show, we'll be discussing Vodafone Idea Limited. The company's shares today fell to below rupees 3 per share on news that the government has demanded that the company calculates and pays it the levies that have arisen as a result of the recent Supreme Court order on the calculation of adjusted gross revenues. The demand could be as high as rupees 40,000 crore, according to some reports, if you were to add the license fees as well as the spectrum usage charges that were due, along with penalties and interest. But Vodafone at the end of June had a cash balance of only around rupees 20,000 crore. So the need of the hour really is that there's a quick cash infusion by its promoters. But both sets of promoters, Vodafone PLC in London, as well as the Birla Group, according to reports, are unwilling to infuse more capital into the company. Note that the company had raised rupees 25,000 crore through a rights issue in which both promoters had participated earlier this year at a price of about rupees 12.5. And the fact that the company's shares have fallen about 75% since then is hardly any incentive to put more capital. And before the merger, Idea's promoters had infused capital along with through a preference issue, which was followed by a QIP issue. That was raised at about 80 to 90 rupees per share, and from there the erosion in value is well over 90%. And so in this backdrop, where the cash that is being raised is also evaporating at rapid pace and the value of those investments are deteriorating, there isn't much incentive for these companies to continue infusing capital, is what they are saying. The telecom industry faces the double whammy of high regulatory levies, taxes, and as well as very low tariffs. When a customer buys a recharge from a telecom company, about 18 rupees goes to the government as goods and services tax. Beyond that, telcos share about 13% of revenues as license fee and spectrum usage charges. And Vodafone's case, about 22 billion rupees every quarter is shared with the government in terms of interest on deferred spectrum liabilities. Note that companies such as Vodafone Idea had bid large amounts to acquire spectrum when spectrum started being auctioned from the year 2012. And as a result of these large liabilities, the interest on due on them also tends to be very large for these companies. So significant portion of revenues get shared with the government in forms of various levies and interest charges. On the other hand, since the entry of Reliance Jio in 2016, tariffs have fallen to very low levels. The industry revenue pie has shrunk by about a third to rupees 1.2 trillion from rupees 1.8 trillion 3 years ago. And so after sharing levies with the government, and what's left is hardly adequate to meet expenses. And so the company has been reporting losses and has been burning cash at a rapid pace in the past many quarters. In this backdrop, it's hardly surprising that the company has asked for relief from the government in the form of a moratorium on the recent demand as a result of the Supreme Court order, or a reduction in interest rate to market linked rates, or even a flow on tariffs. The government, from the looks of it, is hardly in the mood to relent, which explains why the stock fell by over 20% on Thursday. This is ironic because most of the debt owed by the company, about rupees 1 trillion it has in debt, most of it is owed to the government and to government-owned banks. But from the looks of it, and based on how stock market investors are reacting to the news, it seems like a foregone conclusion that this company is heading towards liquidation. So that's all on this Mark to Market show. Please stay tuned on livemint.com for more news and updates. Thank you.